Hi everyone, this is the first part of a two-part tutorial on 3D waterfall painting using acrylic colors. I hope you'll enjoy this video. So let's see the materials required to make this project. We need a thick cardboard or even plywood, or you can even use thermocol for this. Can you see? It is something, a thick base we need, because we are going to stick chart paper onto it. The size of this is 50 × 70 cm. Then we need normal white chart paper, thermocol to create a 3D effect for the rocks. This thermocol I got when we bought the TV, glue gun, the normal white glue, and paint. I've used acrylic paint. Now I'm going to stick this paper onto this thick cardboard using normal white glue, and I'll be fixing the back part for extra secureness. I'll be fixing it with cello tape. Now let's make the rock. Let's carve this thermocol using the fingers into an irregular rock shape. Actually, this is quite a messy work, so please be prepared to spend some time to clean your house once this is done. The bottom surface of the thermocol need not to be carved, as it will aid in the proper placement. So just carve the upper and the side part. Now I'm going to give a rough outline that where we are going to create this waterfall, where we'll stick this rocks. Just a rough outline. So I'm giving a rough outline, so where this rocks need to be stuck. Here we'll be drawing the water, and the other parts will be filled with trees or grass or anything, some greeneries, and the background part. Now I've arranged the rocks. So before sticking onto the cardboard, you can arrange it roughly so that you'll get the idea where to fix. If you want to make any rearrangement, you can do it during this part. And after that, after finalizing the position, you can fix it with glue gun. If you don't have glue gun, you can use normal white glue, that's also okay. But guys, when you're using this glue gun, please do take care and avoid burning your fingers. Actually, you can even choose to apply glue directly to the chart paper and place the rocks later. So I'll be showing the brushes that I've used to make this. Flat brushes, one big and two small. So before proceeding with the painting part, I'm going to show a rough idea of colors that I'll be using and the shading effect that I'll be giving to the rocks. So first I'll be giving the base part normal ivory black color, after that Prussian blue. So the rocks I'll be giving more of a greenish shade, because if you notice, the rocks near the waterfall will be covered with moss. So that is why I'll be giving more of a greenish shade. In between, there should be some grayish shade also. So I've used ivory black, Prussian blue, viridian green, and sap green also. Now you can see in between the rocks, or the conducting areas of the rocks, I'll be giving more of a dark shade. And now I am giving the gray shade to the rocks. That was a rough pattern that how I'll be doing the rocks. So these are the colors that I'll be using, mixing black and white to create a gray. Now I've mixed viridian green and sap green. Before that, we have to give the Prussian blue on the sides. Yeah, one of our rock is ready. And in between the rocks also, we'll be giving a dark shade, and the area where one rock is contacting the other rock, I'll be giving darker shade. You can see here. If you want, you can give a grayish effect more if you prefer to do so. but I'll be giving a more of a greenish effect. So in the same manner, you can finish the entire rock part. You can see in between I've given some reddish shade, crimson red or yellow shade. Make sure you cover all the exposed areas of the rocks with colors and also the area in between the rocks. Yeah, here I'm giving some ochre, yellow ochre on the above part of the rocks. And again continuing with the same pattern. So like in the same manner, you can complete the entire part of rocks. So I advise you not to use much of water. You can see I'm directly applying the paint to the rocks. You'll have to use a good amount of paint to create a good attractive effect. Okay, so we have completed coloring the entire rocks. You can see we have completed it. Now in between the rocks, I'll be filling that area with light blue or sky blue color, and after filling the entire area, we'll be giving the shading effect of a waterfall. For just as a base, have given the sky blue color. So I hope you enjoyed my video. Please like, comment and share with your friends and family, and do subscribe if you have not subscribed to my channel, and stay tuned for the part 2. Thank you.